Hey there everybody, thanks so much for stopping by my channel. Kat here with the Chat with Kat and Friends channel. Just want to inform you, let you know that I'm on every Monday at 6 p.m. Please subscribe to my channel, like, touch the notification bell, all those great things so that I can keep on, so that viewership will get higher. Just share my information, especially if you are blessed by it. If it helps you in any way, please leave your comment, touch the like button and subscribe and all of those great things. I really, really do appreciate it. Look, this channel is all about inspiration and motivation, empowerment, empowering one another. Look, on the Monday coming up, there will not be a Chat with Kat and Friends show. However, we will have one on Wednesday, and I am welcoming the awesome queen that she is, Belinda McCotton, and her business partner, I believe, will also be available on that evening to join us. The CEOs together, the collaborative CEOs of Club and Cycle Fitness. I am so excited to have her on the show. So excited. We will talk with her about her business, about the ups and downs, the challenges, how it is that she became to come in the mindset of being an entrepreneur. Was it something that was instilled in her from her family? Maybe there are other business people inside of her family, entrepreneurs, who knows? It's that way sometimes for some of us, and then for others of us, it is not. It's just a bug that you get, and you just gotta go in it. You just gotta go with it. You probably try different things, different avenues, and they just don't work. It just doesn't work. So it's like, okay, I'm going to blaze my own trail. I'm going to do this thing and have success at it. So that's what you go ahead and do. But blessed be to God, I want to give you guys some inspiration on today, some inspiration on this evening, because it is Thursday evening. So inspiration on this evening to keep on going. Look, yesterday, in my video yesterday, I did a potted plant video. I'm going to stop that. I did a potted plant, repotting my plant video yesterday. And while I was doing it, I talked a little bit and discussed with you guys a little bit about growth. So also in that same vernacular of growth is the pliableness and flexibility to follow through, right? Because in receiving information, even when we're in the place that we need to be and we're getting the information that we need, we have to execute on those things. Look, and I'm speaking to myself too. We have to execute on those things and go forward. In order to go forward, we have to execute on A, B, C, or D. If you're working with a coach, if you're working with a worker of any sort, or you might be that person. You might be the coach or the person that somebody is working with. When you're giving out your instructions, hey, as clients, as people that are trying to be trained and learn more information, and how to harness our expertise and give it out and all of these things, look, monetize it, however it may be, we have to be flexible and willing to execute on the information that is given to us, the ideas, the strategies, the focus measures that it must take, right? So that is also a part of that growth factor in growing. Yesterday I talked about and discussed with you how I had to move my plant from one small planter, from one small pot to a bigger pot, just because the roots on the plant were growing, well, were wanting to grow and needed space to grow and did not have it in the small pot, in the small pot that it was in. So therefore it couldn't grow down. And so if it can't go down and the roots can't grow any further into the ground, then therefore it can't grow up. It won't blossom. It won't bloom. Different leaves won't grow and resurface and be rejuvenated, right? So therefore it had to be placed into a bigger pot. And you might be in that situation, right, where you might be feeling a little stuck or whatever. You can't grow, stifled or whatever. You may have to think about placing yourself in a bigger pond, placing yourself with people that are going to help to motivate you and will influence you in a positive manner. Perhaps not to say that everything is all bad, right? not be all bad, but you could use more positive influences, more inspirational influences. And also, I wanted to just motivate you guys and inspire you toward being increasingly motivated, especially on those days and times when you might not feel so motivated. Look, I can tell you something about that because I'm not always motivated. I'm not always feeling, yes, let's go, let's do it. Nope, and nobody is. In those times, let me tell you, and this is just from experience because this is who I am. This is the life that I've lived, and thankfully, it's gotten to be better. I don't live like in that place of not wanting to do anything, feeling like blah and all of that. I don't live there as long as I used to, and I don't live there at all. Thank you. That takes growth. Look, that's awareness, and that's the energy that you put into different stuff. So you gotta place more energies in that positive stuff so that you won't find yourself in this place of limbo, like having sporadic energy to do things, sporadic motivation or sparks of it, you know. And when those times, just to encourage you that when those times do happen, when they do occur, because we go through challenges, and it could be personal challenges or indirect things that we are affected emotionally, we are affected psychologically in some ways. I already said emotionally, and it can put a damper on how you feel, how much work you do, whether you want to work at all. You know, all of those things can play a big factor in that. So in those days and times, it's important to be connected with people who can bring you back to a motivated place, or at least pour into you some of the things that you know, and having that fertile ground and knowledge of knowing who you are, whose you are, of your greatness, of your wonderfully and fearfully made, that you had the victory. Being reminded of that can re-spark your motivation, re-spark your inspiring self, right? And your inspirable self, in that you inspire others or you motivate others. It re-sparks that, because there are things that's going on in our lives and challenges that we face in and out. How timing is of God only knows. God only knows. But there are things that we face, challenges that we face, way more ups than downs, I pray. And for me, thank you, Lord, way more ups than downs these days and times. But feeling that emotional plight, and dealing with like things in the news and just the barrage of things, therefore can bring you down, can subdue your motivation, can dampen your inspirational self. And in those days and times, it's so important to connect, that we reach out to one another, and that we connect with one another in some way, shape, or form. Of course, we want to do it in a safe manner, and we want to keep in mind limitations and restrictions that are upon us right now. Do it in a way that is healthy and helpful, and not putting you in any kind of compromising situations. So that being said, just wanted to pass on some inspiration and some empowerment on today. That's what this channel is all about. It is evening, and prayerfully tomorrow I'll be back with Friday motivation as well. Friday tomorrow, I typically Fearless Friday, Freedom Friday, all of those things. To just put a name, motivated Fearless Friday, put a name on the days to stamp it. So to get up with the mindset that I'm gonna go, with the mindset that it's not your intent. I don't think it's anybody's intention ever to be dragged down, bogged down, or to be on the receiving end of negativity. I don't think so. But it happens, right? It happens, right? So I pray that you bounce back quickly, that those who know you, that we like surround one another and we call out to each other, you know, speaking those words of life, speaking that we can be fulfilled and uplifted, especially in those times when we're not feeling so much so. And that does happen. It is a real thing. You are not alone. You may be saying and thinking to yourself, you know, nobody else feels this, and this is not right, and that, you know, all of these things. But you're not by yourself by a long shot. You're not by yourself by a long shot. I have come to the knowledge and learning and experience in that, you're not alone. I'm not alone. Thanks be to God. So when you place your unique talent, your gift, your personality, along with that idea that you have for breaking out and busting out into a different field of business, of providing services, go for it, go for it. I pray that you do well, that you stay, live up to the task, that you are able to execute in every manner that you need to. I'm praying these things over myself as well, that you speak life into yourself and others, and that it is reciprocated right back to you 10 times over. So you guys, that's it for me tonight. Just wanted to leave you guys with some inspiration on this Thursday evening, this thankful Thursday evening. I am so thankful for you, thankful for the strength that we have, especially when we gather together, whether it's virtual, whether it's physically, and all of those things, don't on Zoom, however that should look. I'm thankful for the gathering. I'm thankful for the connection, the communication, and all of those things. If you have a black business or know of a black business, please send me the information. I love to have you as a guest on the Cat Chat and Friends Now show. I thank you. Please subscribe to my channel, share my channel, comment, let me know what's going on, especially if you're being blessed by the information that is left here. If you're being blessed by any of the videos, check out that business strategist, Catherine Trotter. There's so many people, Tamaya Stewart. There are so many people that I have interviewed, on my channel. One Sharp Lady, Brandon Moody, there are others, Tanika Coleman, check them out. Look, Lady Q, Scott Simone, check them out. Check out their websites. These are black business owners, small and large, being scaled, and they are like fearlessly going forward in the skills, the arts that they know of, the creativity that was sparked within them to just go, to just blaze a trail and do things that they haven't done. It might have been done by this person and that person, but they haven't done it, and it hasn't been done to the specificity. I'm messing that word up. It hasn't been done to the specifics of how they could do it, how you can do it, how you can portray it, how when you put your personality to it, your creativity to it, your personalized situation on it, it looks totally different, and it's received in a different manner. So may you be blessed. May you have a great night. And I'll see you guys on tomorrow. Check out my video from yesterday when I potted my beautiful plant. I am so happy. I'm so proud of myself. And it is growing, and it is standing up a little bit straighter than it did yesterday because it needed that extra space. So if you need that extra space, look, sit down and think about your current situation, where you are, and all those things. And think about if you need a bigger pot, if you need a bigger, you know, if you need to spread your wings a little bit. And maybe sometimes it's time to let some things go. We had to let that little pot go and bring in something bigger. Plan it. I'm not telling you to drop nobody or nothing without thinking and without planning, but do your due diligence and your research and your thinking about your situation. Add some wisdom to it. Look, pray about it, and look, shake, stir, and let it go. And let it go. Look, like a recipe. God be praised. So I am thankful for you on the night. God loves you the most. I love you. God loves you the most. And he knows what's best for you and what's coming for you too. So lean on him. Lean on him on today. I will see you guys on tomorrow. Have a great night.